the quick pitch gets the ball outside, and McClendon throws the key blocker in the corner, and then McNabb has the balance to shake off the last tackling attempt and scoot into the corner.
Arden Krzyzewski with the extra point attempt.
It is good, and the Gators have taken a 7-0 lead as they have marched from one end of the field to the other in just five plays offensively, shoving it into the end zone against the Oklahoma State Cowboys. And a joyous crowd of better than 72,000 celebrates this Gator football team. And now that University of Florida defense, highly ranked, highly regarded, so much expected of this group of football players, huddling down on the near sideline with new defensive coordinator Jim Bates.
Oh, and he's an excellent coach too, David. Steve Spurrier was very excited about the chance of bringing in Jim Bates, to coach the Gator defense. Gary Darnell was the defensive coordinator of the great Gator defense last year. Gary Darnell played at Oklahoma State. He was a Cowboy in the late 60s. Now he's gone on to Notre Dame as a defensive coordinator. But Jim Bates has strong credentials, and he was very impressed with the speed of the defense that he inherited. I think, what, 8 or 9 starters coming back on this Gator defense?
8 starters returning from a group that was 3rd in the nation, tops of the SEC, and defense last season. Off to the Gators, freshman Ryan Rulin, who puts the toe into it, and Curtis Mayfield, 5 yards deep in the end zone, will have to drop the one knee. Oklahoma State will bring it out to the 20. A nice job of kicking off by redshirt freshman Ryan Rulin. And the Oklahoma State offense comes onto the field to get its first look at that rugged Gator defense. New defensive formation that Jim Bates brings to the program. There's the offensive line first for Oklahoma State. Young group. Surratt, the veteran center. And from the 20-yard line, quarterback Chris Smith at the helm. Going on first down. And he slides ahead to the 25-yard line. A gain of 5 yards on first down. Tim Paul was there to make sure that Smith did not get away. Excellent pass coverage of that Gator defense, led by the All-American Huey Richardson at that left end position. Solid all the way across the front there. Steve Bartley, Tim Falk, Jerry Odom, the senior leader of this ball club, and a defensive secondary that features a potential All-American and cornerback Richard Fain. Second down and 5 for Oklahoma State. To the tailback, Hudson, who fights his way across the 30 and gets the first down
to the 32-yard line. This young man, a solid, and Cecil Wilson, rather, the fullback. Godfrey Miles made the stop on senior Cecil Wilson, but Hudson, the tailback in this offensive attack, carried the ball 33 times last week against Tulsa. Wilson normally does the blocking for the tailback, but got the handoff on that second down play, and perhaps caught the Gator defense a bit by surprise. First down and 10 from the 32-yard line.
Smith has the ball tipped at the line of scrimmage, and it is incomplete. Mike Brandon, the 6'4" defensive tackle out of Perry in Taylor County High School, reached up and slapped it away.
A lot of size up front for the Gators, and once they can't get any further penetration, the guys get their arms up and try and pre-get the quarterback, and that takes the ball to the ball.
It is second down and 10.
Blitz.
And the pass is just dumped away on the near sideline. Jerry Odom, the inside linebacker, was applying the pressure on the blitz.
Curtis Mayfield didn't read the blitzing inside linebacker right there and continued down the field with his long pass route, and the quarterback had no choice but to throw the ball away. Generally, a receiver's got to keep his eyes, take a peek at the linebacker, see what they're doing first, then break his route off and give his quarterback a chance to come up with a completion. But right there, a busted play because of the pressure from the Gator defense.
Oklahoma State has left one setback. That's Wilson. quick approaching the all-time quarterback sack lead in University of Florida football history. Set a school record last year. I think he needs just five now to pass Alonzo Johnson in career quarterback sacks.
A lot of pressure coming from the outside. There's Huey and there's Mark. And we saw in the first passing attempt, Smith stepped up and ran the ball. And you're going to see quarterbacks step up a lot with that pressure coming from the outside.
Blanchard kicks it away to Terrence Barber, who fair catches the ball. It's the 47-yard line. The Raiders will have good field position and a 7-0 lead early in the first period.
Now, I'm going to call this great field position, David, because the Gators have a 7-0 lead. The defense comes out and shuts them down, giving up one first down. And then with the short punt, look at the Gators very near the 50-yard line. And if they continue with the potent offense we saw, should be an exciting afternoon.
The Gators have one running back, Dexter McNabb. The tailback, Willie McClendon, is in a slot to the left side. Matthews passing again. He's going deep for Trey Everett, and he overthrew everybody at about the 10-yard line. Joe Keane, senior quarterback. And solid coverage on Trey Everett.
Joe King and Mike Clark are excellent quarterbacks. Each of them coming up with an interception against the Tulsa Hurricane last week. Both veteran corners starting 2 and 3 years for the Cowboys, so they got a lot of quality at that quarterback position.
Alonzo Sullivan is now split wide to the right. Terrence Barber to the left. A handoff goes, however, to McClendon. And McClendon fights his way to the 46-yard line of Oklahoma State, a pickup of 7 yards. Tackled by the inside linebacker, Clarence Noble.
Carl Franks is coaching the offensive backs for the Gators. He was a former fullback at Duke for Steve Spurrier, and this is a draw lead, which the Gators will feature with their potent passing attack. You'll see that play quite often during the season.
From the 46, they fumbled a snap, and no indication yet. Gators signaling that they've got the football, but now so is Oklahoma State. And indeed, it looks like the Cowboys have recovered it. Willie McClendon had an excellent chance to lay on that football. I don't know how it scored it loose, but let's take a look.
Matthews never gets the snap.
Bruce Bradley also had a shot at the loose ball. But somebody for Oklahoma State fell on. So there's the first turnover of Spurrier ball.
What would you call that in tennis? Unforced error, right?
That's exactly what it was. The Cowboys have good field position for the first time in the game. And Hudson is now the eye back. As he takes the handoff, flags are everywhere. Hudson is thrown for a loss by Jerry Odom. Loss of about 3 or 4 yards. It looked like maybe somebody jumped the gun for the Gators.
A couple of defenders got antsy there, David, and anticipated the snap count. These kids are pumped up. They're excited. But that time they jumped across the neutral zone. And now Oklahoma State has great field position inside that 50-yard line.
Interesting that Hudson was not used on their first offensive series. With 42 carries a week ago, they came out with the one-back set in their first offensive set against the Gators. And now they're running out of a straight eye. That's Parker in motion. Hudson stumbles across the 45. They'll spot him down at the 45-yard line.
Godfrey Miles,
couple of yards short of the first down,
making the tackle right there. Hudson gained close to 1,000 yards last year and didn't play in 3 ball games because of an injury.
After their first 4 games last season, he was ranked 3rd in the nation in rushing the football. He had averaged 137 yards per game before he suffered a knee injury in the 4th game of the year.
Of course, last year he was replacing the great Barry Sanders, who dominated their winning attack for the Cowboys.
Hudson got hit by Brandon first. Then Richardson finished him off with help from his friends. The loss of a couple back to about the 47. Godfrey Miles also.
It's just Brandon dominating the line of scrimmage right there, and no one was able to control him. He just messed up that play entirely with his penetration.
Florida leads Oklahoma State 7-0. We are midway through the first period. It is third down and 5 for the Cowboys. It has come with a blitz again. Smith throws, and it is caught by Ronnie Fisher, but not enough to a first down. Ephesians Bartley completes the pitch, makes the tackle.
Peters center inside linebackers, and Fee Bartley's man for man on the back, and he does come up with a tackle short of the first down marker, so that's a great play by Fee Bartley, who was on his own out there, but made the hit and the tackle short of the first down.
Terrence Barber back to receive the kick from Kerry Blanchard. And it is not a good kick. Off the side of his foot, they'll mark it out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. Florida leads Oklahoma State 7-0 midway through the first period from Florida Field.
Ball just a bit over his head, but he had his hands on it right there. But Shane, for the first time this afternoon, is forced out of the pocket. Now he's going to get some heat from the backside. I think he feels his pressure, but he doesn't throw the ball wildly. He throws it well. McClendon just couldn't come up with a catch.
The Gators got most of that yardage on their first offensive possession when they drove about 70 yards for the touchdown. Second down and 10. Dexter McNabb to the 24-yard line, a gain of about 7 on the play. Linebacker Mike Woolridge, a sophomore out of Kansas City, Missouri, number 47, made the tackle for Oklahoma State. McNabb, after that Big Mac backfield for the Florida Gators, he and Willie McClendon, a pair of juniors, trying to fill the void left by Emmitt Smith, who is now a Dallas Cowboy.
And Cedric Smith, who's now a Minnesota Viking, I believe.
That's right. Third down and 3. Again over the middle. Terrence Barber has the first down and more to the 35-yard line. Mike Clark.
First down call.
Made the tackle for Oklahoma State.
David, you're going to see Clarence Nobles, a freshman linebacker, dropping back in the middle of your screen right there. But the quarterback, Matthews, takes what they give him, which is the short dump pass right there. And that's what Steve Spurrier wants his guys to do. Take what they give you. Don't force the ball anyplace. Pick up 8 or 9 yards when you can dump it to a back or a wide receiver on a short route.
Next to McNabb, the fullback. Lowers his shoulder and drives to the 41-yard line. Good yardage on first down. A gain of about 7.
I mentioned Nobles a few minutes ago. He's one of 4 freshmen starting for the Cowboys on defense. Now, that's very unusual for a program that's that successful as the Cowboys to start 4 freshmen on defense.
A probation mark program. The NCAA hit them with a probation a couple of years ago. They were 4-7 last season. This is tailback Eric Rett getting the first down across the 45 to about the 47-yard line. Let's go down to the sideline. This is Steve Battle. Steve?
You know, David and Jim, one thing you can't teach in practice is how to handle yourself under pressure with 70,000 fans yelling. Shane Matthews having to call the signals over a loud crowd noise down there. Very deafening. Very impressed with his poise right now. Also, when he audibles at the line, he's getting his receivers to the right play. I'm very impressed with his poise right now.
Reminds me a little bit of the Florida offense when Mike Shanahan was the offensive coordinator and Wayne Pease was the quarterback. From the 47-yard line, it's now first down again. An Oklahoma State player jumped off but got back in time. Pass is batted away at the line of scrimmage. I think Jason Gilden, the big tackle at 6'4", 215, reached up and slapped it away. And we'll bring up second down. A future Florida opponent, Furman University, opened its season today against Presbyterian College with a big victory. Of course, next week, the Gators will take on Alabama in Tuscaloosa. Second down and 10.
Tight end punt for Patrick. Steve Spurrier has been calling this guy an all-star candidate ever since he took a look at him last spring when he arrived at the campus.
Mike Woolridge, sophomore linebacker, has Kirkpatrick initially, but Kirk has too much speed, runs away from the linebacker, and just before Jay Fleischman gets there, the ball's delivered. An excellent route and a beautiful pass by Shane Matthews. Both the tight end and the quarterback doing an excellent job right there. And one thing Steve Spurrier loves to do is feature the tight end in his offense. And you look at Kirk Kirkpatrick, the senior from Valrico, which is in the Brandon area.
Whistles blow and stop the action as Eric Rett took the handoff from Shane Matthews. I also think that Matthews had checked off on that last play and audibleized at the line of scrimmage. Delay of game. The Gators let the clock run out on him. That'll cost him 5 yards. Back to the 30.
That's not going to happen that often because Steve Spurrier calls the plays. He calls them with signals right from the sideline. He's not waiting for someone in the skybox or the booth up here to send down a play to him. He's the guy doing it. So very rarely will you see that happening. There he's getting a little bit antsy right now. He says, what's going on? Get up there.
Clock is down to 6 now. Matthews takes the snap. And just throws it away. Oklahoma State wanting an intentional grounding call, but Alonzo Sullivan was about 10 yards downfield from where the ball landed, but it looks like they've got the call.
Well, I think it's a good call. I don't think Matthews did a good job of throwing the ball far enough away, although that might not be the call at all. Maybe they're calling something else. He's erasing it.
I think the official who threw the flag did not see Sullivan downfield a few
He does the right thing, but not forcing the screen pass to the right. He does throw it away, but he's got to put a little, he's probably better off just throwing it in the stands than throwing it in the ground. But hey, the guy only took 3 snaps all last year, didn't he?
Two. He did it off twice against Louisiana Tech. And you can see what he's done already this afternoon.
Yeah, 60% pass completions.
Good protection. And the pass is caught at the 18-19 yard line by Alonzo Sullivan.
Well, I think the thing that impressed Steve Spurrier the most about Shane Matthews and why Shane Matthews is starting is his consistency. And we've seen that so far in the first quarter. This kid's playing an excellent ball game. He's not doing dumb things. He's using his head, and he's got the skill to deliver the football. Now we got a timeout. The coach is calling timeout.
With 3 minutes and 51 seconds left in the first period, and Florida on top 7-0. Gators use a timeout to talk things over deep in Oklahoma State territory once again. We'll be right back. He's had no solutions to the Gator offense as well.
He's doing a Jerry Tarkanian impression over there with his towel. Steve Spurrier's got him sweating bullets.
It's 3rd and 5 for the Gators at the Oklahoma State 20. Play action. Man wide open. Kirkpatrick fights his way down near the goal line, and I don't think he got in. He got awfully close. What tremendous individual effort by the senior tight end, Jay Fleischman. Just barely kept him out of the end zone.
I think this is a delay. That's why Kirkpatrick gets so free. They forget about him. Initially, he just doesn't come out on his route, I don't believe. He can't pick it all up, but all of a sudden he's wide open. Now watch him use his athletic ability here to cut back, and Jay Fleischman is one of the top defensive backs in the Big 8. And Kirkpatrick almost sneaks by him for the touchdown.
Two tight end offense at the goal line. Oklahoma's got him stacked up there. Matthews goes over the top and in for the touchdown. And the young quarterback's first touchdown is this.
I think I've got a permanent grin on my face. It won't come off. This is so much fun to watch this offense go up and down the field. We're not used to seeing that consistency.
Krzyzewski will attempt the extra point. It is good. It's 14-0. We're still in the first period. I think, Jim, you just made a point that probably running through the minds of Gator fans all over the Sunshine State right now. When was the last time that you saw a Florida football team just march up and down the field against an opponent? And we're not talking about Prairie View A&T here this afternoon. Oklahoma State is a legitimate Big 8 football team.
Oh, yeah, they held, as we mentioned, Tulsa to a total of 159 yards total offense in last week's ballgame. The Gators already have 162 yards total offense with 3 minutes and 20 seconds yet to go in the first quarter. And the only drive that the Gators were stopped on, they stopped themselves with the fumble.
Steve Spurrier has been telling us that he liked the quality of the quarterbacks and especially the receivers.
But he also, I think, David, was a little bit of afraid of his offense somewhat because the Gator defense had been so dominating in preseason practice. He really felt like his offense wasn't where he wanted it to be, and he was a little concerned about it, but I think he's a little less concerned right now.
Of course, it is still very early in this game, but the Gators have been totally dominating to this point. Total yardage figures, 162-1, or 4 rather, for Oklahoma State. The youngster Rulin kicks it away. Curtis Mayfield from the goal line. Mayfield, a dangerous return man, brings it out to the 25.
Monty Groh, number 10, who's had an excellent preseason practice, backup safety, played as a true freshman last year for the Gators, making the tackle right there, along with Harvey Thomas. Big, strong defensive end that was down there hustling.
Senior quarterback Chris Smith taking over for Mike Gundy, the most successful passer in Oklahoma State football history, who finished up his eligibility a year ago. And Smith is really getting a tough go of it against a swarming Gator defense here in his debut as a starting quarterback. Hudson is tackled behind the line. He got back to the line of scrimmage, but Carlton Miles, the linebacker, came shooting through the gap. There's Miles out of Daytona Beach, Father Lopez High School. Did not play a whole lot last year for the Gator defense, but very quick, strong football player. This defense figures to be one of the tops, not only in the Southeastern Conference, but nationally, as it was a year ago. Rollout pass. Smith feels the pressure again and then just throws it away. Hudson was out there at about the 25-yard line, but he had turned to throw a block on a Gator defender and was not even looking when the pass was thrown by Smith.
Yeah, we're not sure if they were trying to get the ball to Curtis Mayfield, the wide receiver, who was also on that same side of the field, but nonetheless, the pressure was there.
Mayfield, the top returning wide receiver in the Big 8 Conference. Of course, that's not a conference that's well known for passing football, but Curtis Mayfield's an excellent athlete at wide receiver.
Well, he caught 49 with Mike Gundy throwing last year. Third down and 10. That's Mayfield at the top of your screen. Smith throws over the middle, however, and there's a completed pass to Robert Kirksey. And it is good for an Oklahoma State first down. Richard Fain, an All-American candidate cornerback, was covering, but Kirksey made the play, a junior out of St. Louis, Missouri. And that's his first reception of the season. He caught 12 last year. A quick scoring summary. The first possession marched 83 yards for the touchdown. That is their last possession, and the touchdown plunged by Shane Matthews. That was the second touchdown of the afternoon. It is 14-0. Hudson has a little bit of room around the right side, and Fain trips him up, but not before he picked up about 8 yards, did Gerald Hudson.
Well, the Cowboys do a nice job here of trapping Huey Richardson and bouncing outside. Huey refuses to give ground, so he forces Hudson to bounce outside, but there's no help. Once they get beyond Huey, were able to pick up 8 or 9 yards. So that's an excellent offensive trap by the Cowboys on that play.
Second and two. This is the fullback, Cecil Wilson, gaining the first down across the 50-yard line. So back-to-back first downs for the first time this afternoon by Oklahoma State. And them across the 50. Michael Brandon, there to make the stop.
Wilson, a lot like the Gators' Cedric Smith last year. Big Cedric was capable of carrying that football. Wilson, also a returning starter. He and Hudson started in the backfield for the Cowboys last year, so a lot of experience back there. Only the quarterback is new.
Short drop. Pass caught by Parker. There's Steve Bartley. Carlton Miles to make sure that Parker goes nowhere. Again, the
hold pass and post to Parker.
David, we were talking about the Gator speed on defense. Parker kid, Brent Parker, was one of the fastest 400-meter sprinters in the nation in high school. So he's a dangerous kid when he gets loose, but he's not going anywhere there. Look, 5 Gators on top of him. And that's a result of that team speed. One guy gets you, then another one hits you, then the third and fourth. But Steve Bartley, the outstanding junior, number 44, was the first guy to make the hit.
Second and 8. The one back is Wilson. Man-to-man coverage. Mayfield is interfered with. I think it's going to be the call by Jimmy Spencer. Quarterback out, man-to-man coverage on Mayfield. And the penalty flag was thrown.
Well, Spencer really gets caught in a trap right here because Mayfield has him beat, but then the ball is laid up high. Smith throws kind of a floater. Spencer makes up the ground quickly on Mayfield and then runs into him. See him right there? He bumped into him just before that. Mayfield definitely had him beat. If the bomb had been there properly, it would have been a touchdown, but it was a bit underthrown, and then Spencer runs into the wide receiver. So in college football, the penalty is marked off from the line of scrimmage. They come back to the line of scrimmage and march off 15 yards.
Gators have already been penalized 3 times so far. Oklahoma State has not seen the yellow flag thrown their way.
2 penalties on the Gator defense, 1 on the Gator offense.
Only 6 seconds left in the first period. This is the third first down of this drive by Oklahoma State, by far their best offensive possession. They've tightened up their offensive line to cut down on the
back of the Gator defense. Hudson found a crack. All the way to the 10-yard line, or inside the 10, goes Gerald Hudson. Gerald Odom brought him down. They'll spot him at the 8 as the first period ends from Florida Field in Gainesville. With that score, the Gators 14, the Cowboys of Oklahoma State nothing. We'll be right back.
It took over in 1984.
You got to give both coaches credit for the success of Oklahoma State football.
Last year they were 4-7, but they were very disappointed with that, and they expected to rebound quickly here in the 1990 season.
Well, they threaten as the second period begins. Wilson is hit near the line by Huey Richardson and Tim Paulk, and may have gotten a yard. Paulk was the primary man, number 99, the junior out of Miami. Dexter Smith, also in on the play, a sophomore out of Wichita, Kansas. You can see that Paulk hit him there first. And then Smith helped out. Second down and goal from the 7-yard line. And Smith fumbles the snap, and there's Mr. Godfrey Miles to say hello in the backfield.
Well, Oklahoma State's trying to create a little confusion with their motion, and I think they're doing that to the Gator defense right now, but that was just a poor exchange. The Gators had one of those, gave the ball up near the 50-yard line. That time, Oklahoma State luckily maintains possession. That would have been a disaster for them after a very successful drive like this one to give the ball up on a turnover. But helped the Gators out there a bit. Now it's third and long, and they haven't thrown that well.
And they call timeout to make sure of the offensive play. So Chris Smith walks over to the sideline to talk with Pant Jones and the coaching staff for Oklahoma State. Football team that held Tulsa last week, as we mentioned earlier, to just 3 points. It was the fewest points that an
opponent of Oklahoma State has scored since the 1987 season. And they were excited about their defensive team coming into this game, having completely shut down a good offensive team at Tulsa University, led by one of the top quarterbacks in college football, T.J. Rudley. But this afternoon, at least in the first period, they found no answers to the Gator offense. But their offense, on the other hand, Jim, has really come to life here late in the first period. They've made a couple of adjustments and have been running it right at the Florida defense.
They put the tight end in motion. They put some wide receivers in motion. But most of all, what they're doing is winning the physical battle at the line of scrimmage on this drive. Very impressive drive by the Cowboys. And they're winning the battle at the point of attack. And you got to do that on occasion if you're going to move that football consistently and get the opponent's end zone. So a very, very impressive drive by the Cowpokes right now. And the Gators are facing a big third down and long situation.
Vernon Brown is now the tailback in the I formation. Kirksey in motion. Flags everywhere, and they'll stop play as Odom and Richardson both have Smith dead in their sights. Smith not very happy with almost getting sacked for no reason, with the play having already been blown dead. But it's tough to shut that engine off just like that when you're so close to getting that quarterback back. Will Odom Olsen is the ball against Oklahoma State. And he will push them back 5 more yards, and now they're third and goal from just about the 15.
Oklahoma State has left 5 yards for Peter.
And you wonder, as the day wears on, how the heat here in Central Florida could affect this Oklahoma State football team as well. Smith has good protection. He's throwing to the end zone, and Mayfield, he's got it. Touchdown, Cowboys.
A timing pass to Mayfield, and the ball was delivered right in front of Spencer. Jimmy Spencer on the coverage right there. Mayfield running a corner route. And Smith, before the break, the ball's in the air. Mayfield turns around, and there it is. Just an excellent timing route by the Cowboys, and they're on the scoreboard.
Blanchard with the extra point. It is good. That was Chris Smith's first touchdown pass for Oklahoma State, by the way, in his career. And it's 14-7 ball game. So a big play offensively on third down and goal for the Cowboys. They have come early in half. It's now 14-7 with Oklahoma State kicking off to the Gators when we come back.
Teeing it up. Oklahoma State has just marched down the field to cut the lead to 14-7. Using the outstanding wide receiver, Curtis Mayfield, on a couple of big plays. I'm not sure if they were picking on Jimmy Spencer or just utilizing the talents of Curtis Mayfield.
Probably a little of both.
Blanchard kicks it deep. And that's Kurt Young fumbling it and falling on it in the end zone. Florida will have the ball at its own 20-yard line as play resumes early in the second period, with the Florida Gators leading the Oklahoma State Cowboys by the score of 14-7. The Gators have still outgained Oklahoma State by a wide margin, 164-69. But now the score much closer. Broadcast rights to today's telecast have been granted to Sports Channel Florida by the University of Florida solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any reproduction, retransmission, or the use of this program without the express written consent of Sports Channel Florida is prohibited. Sophomore quarterback Shane Matthews has two receivers to the right, one to the left, as he rolls to the right side and finds Ernie Mills open. And Mills steps out of bounds at the 27-yard line. Gain of 8.
I think he called that play at the line of scrimmage. He was up there quite a bit, and you see his head bobbing around. He's shouting out instructions to his teammates. I think the young quarterback simply saw the defense develop and called the play at the line of scrimmage.
Oklahoma State, a very impressive drive. 75 yards and 11 plays. And Mayfield with his first touchdown reception of the season. And the first touchdown pass in the career of senior Chris Smith. Straight ahead running by Willie McClendon. Gets the first down and five more out near the 35-yard line. He was tripped up by outside linebacker Richie Ansley, a freshman.
Big Stacy Satter, White, number 52 at the line of scrimmage, almost gets him. But he breaks the tackle right there. McClendon, big strong running back. Again, the Gators no longer blessed with the running talents of the great Emmett Smith, and now the pressure is on Willie McClendon to deliver.
Well, McClendon had 510 yards himself in a part-time role last year. Play action. Everett wide open. Everett first down to the 46-yard line of Oklahoma State. Jay Fleischman knocked him down, but the Gators have another first down.
A deep zone and just beyond the linebackers, underneath the defensive backs, before Fleischman can make the hit. He's excited about that hit that he makes on Everett. It was an excellent hit, but it was after the ball was caught, and the Gators continue to move on offense.
Everett had not caught a pass for the Gators until today. He's caught two so far. McClendon running a trap, gets tripped up by Ansley after he picks up about 3 yards to the 43-yard line of Oklahoma State. Ansley picked up 40 pounds in the weight room in the offseason. A redshirt freshman.
One of those
out of Dallas, Texas.
One of those four freshman starters we mentioned. Very unusual for a program like Oklahoma State to start four freshmen. Generally, it takes you a couple of years to work your way into the lineup.
Matthews has good protection again. He threads it once again right on the numbers of Trey Everett, who is down to the 27-yard line of Oklahoma State. Charles Berner made the stop.
David, you know what is so exciting to see is these wide receivers read the defense. The quarterback reads the defense. Then they adjust their pass route in accordance with what they see, and that's why they're so wide open. You know, they're reading on the move. It's called reading on the move, and Coach Spurrier has the wideouts and the quarterbacks on the same page in this ball game.
Everett and Mills, the wide receivers. The tight end, Kirkpatrick, in a slot. That's Kirkpatrick in motion. McClendon with a lot of room. Gets away from Fleischman. Gets away from Clark. Out of bounds at the 11-yard line. Berner finally took him out of bounds.
And it's Ernie Mills' hustle here at the bottom of your screen that you're going to see. Ernie Mills downfield staying with his block. McClendon's going to break the tackle here, and there's Ernie Mills fighting. The worst thing in the world for a wide receiver is to fall down, you know, to get out there and fall down at a guy. Stay up, stay in his face, get in his way, help your back out. And that's exactly what Ernie Mills did right there. He hustled, stayed in the way, and McClendon picked up an extra 5 or 6 yards because of it.
McClendon gets a break, only one back. Two wide receivers to the left, one to the right. Matthews changing the play, and he's just about run out of time, and he did run out of time before he could make the timeout call. The clock ran down on him, and that'll be a 5-yard penalty. Or did he get the timeout call? Yeah, looks like he did call timeout before they threw the flag. Timeout, Florida Gators. With 11:22 left in the second period, and the Gators on top of Oklahoma State 14-7. You see how warm it is here. The temperature expected to reach the upper 90s here in Gainesville. And I know that grass, natural grass surface, has cut down on the heat down on the field, but those fans in the stands probably don't feel a whole lot of difference. Steve Spurrier chatting with Shane Matthews, now sends the youngster back out into the huddle. A young man who had taken only 2 snaps in a regular season game. He had an outstanding spring game last year, and that's really what got him a good strong look for the starting job against Kyle Morris, who was last year's starting quarterback.
And Brian Fox, who in 1988 was the rookie of the year in the Big Ten at Purdue and then transferred last year, sat out the season. Brian Fox, an excellent quarterback from West Orange, which is in the Orlando area. But it's Matthews who's won the job, started at number 5, I think, on the list of quarterbacks initially.
Matthews looks to throw. Kirkpatrick in the end zone, can't make the catch. Just off of his fingertips. He was covered by Woolridge, a linebacker. who had him man-to-man.
And he's beat. And he throws an excellent soft pass that the tight end at least has a chance to catch. It would have been a one-handed grab. Kirkpatrick does his job. Oh, just can't quite get to it. But much like Mayfield's pass route, running to the corner, he was there. They just didn't get the ball to him.
Again, a one-back set for the Gators on second down. From the 12-yard line of Oklahoma State for the end zone again. Tight end dropped the ball. The sophomore tight end out of New Orleans could not hold on. Richie Ansley had him covered, but the pass was there.
Greg Keller, who was one of the few true freshmen to play for the Gators last year, would almost comes up with a terrific catch here, but I think he might be stripped of it at the last second. Let's see. He's got it. No, he just couldn't hang on to it. Great protection. Let's pay some tribute to that offensive line. Again, the quarterback, Matthews, having plenty of time, and he's delivering the football. Keller just couldn't come up with the catch.
Now it's third down from the 12. The clock down to one, and they took too much time again. Matthews trying to audibleize at the line of scrimmage and ran out of time. Steve Spurrier can't be altogether happy with that.
Well, one thing he doesn't want to happen is a consistent bit of confusion among his own players on offense. And so far this afternoon, that's not been a problem at all. It's just maybe Matthews trying to do a little too much with his checking at the line of scrimmage.
McClendon is now the lone running back. Flags fly again for the end zone. Mills cannot hold on to it. May have been deflected there in the end zone by Woolridge, or Fleischman rather, number 48. There's Fleischman, who I think got a piece of it. But there are penalty flags back around the line of scrimmage.
Shane Matthews again right on the button. Ernie has a chance, but it's Fleischman knocking the ball away. And they might decline this penalty. It seems to be against the Gators.
The illegal procedure, I think, is the call. It looks like Oklahoma State is going to decline. Declined by the Cowboys, so that'll bring up fourth down. And the field goal unit, Johnny Nichols, will hold. And Arden Krzyzewski will try to kick one in from 33 yards out. Hasn't missed one yet for the Gators. From the right hash mark, Krzyzewski's kick is good. A 33-yard field goal by Arden Krzyzewski, a junior out of Tampa Bay, puts the Gators on top 17-7. We are early in the second period from Florida Field. At about the 22-yard line, and that once again is Harvey Thomas, who's been on a couple of special team plays already this afternoon.
Harvey Thomas knocked down the attempted blocker and then made the tackle. That's hard to do. Just a terrific job right there. It was a very short kick. Gators are lucky to hold Oklahoma State so close to their own 20-yard line with such a short kick.
The Gators added that Krzyzewski field goal after driving at 64 yards. The drive bogged down at the Oklahoma State 12-yard line. Mayfield and Parker, the wide receivers. But the handoff goes to the tailback, Gerald Hudson, who fights his way out to about the 25-yard line. A pickup of 2 or 3 yards on the play. It'll be second down and 8. James Spear made the tackle to the Gator defense.
Once again, Chris Smith, the quarterback for the Cowboys, as we see Hudson limping off the field. We hope he's not hurt too badly. Looks like he might pull the muscle, but Chris Smith had about the same kind of experience that Shane Matthews had. Very little coming into this 1990 season.
Smith threaded the needle that time to Mayfield, who catches the ball and steps out of bounds at about the 39-yard line. Jimmy Spencer again covering him man-to-man. And Mayfield is taking advantage of the one-on-one situation. An experienced wide receiver who has caught 67 passes in his career at Oklahoma State coming into this game.
First down, Oklahoma State.
Against an inexperienced cornerback. And Jimmy Spencer is doing a nice job. He's close, but close doesn't count because Mayfield comes up with a big reception.
Hit in the backfield is the tailback, Vernon Brown. As Jerry Odom got there to make the stop near the line of scrimmage. James Spear also in on the tackle.
Spear and Odom.
Odom, really a coach's dream for a player.
Coach's son.
Yep.
Gerald Odom, his dad played for the Gators a few years before Coach Spurrier started for the Gators. His dad's a head coach at Merritt Island High School, but this kid is a coach on the field. He'll probably be a coach one day as well.
I can remember when Odom came to the program, what, 4 years ago? It was said by many that he would never play for the University of Florida. Just wasn't good enough. He's proven critics wrong. Smith.
Oh, Huey almost got it.
And then did get him from behind at the 35-yard line.
He's James pounding.
Spear got him from the front, and Huey got him from behind.
David Huey's pounding the ground, not because he didn't make a good tackle, but because he missed his golden opportunity to intercept the ball and dance into the end zone. He's 6'5", almost 6'6". He had one big paw in the air and almost got it, and that would have been a dream come true for him. But that was a very dangerous situation for the Cowpokes, and now they face a third and long.
James Spear made another nice play, a veteran. He's been around this program in a variety of different roles for the Gators. Third and long. Long count by Smith. Here comes Spear. The senior out of Miami. He's been an outside linebacker. He's been a special team star for the Florida Gators. And he's having himself a big afternoon on the natural grass at Florida Field.
Well, no one touches him either. That's pretty easy to have a big afternoon when you're not blocked. But he's coming from that Gatorback position, which is the new position that Coach Jim Bates has created with this attacking defense, similar to the Monster Man defense that Coach Ray Graves invented when he was here coaching the Gators.
Blanchard really unloads on this one. Barber calls for and makes a fair catch at the 32-yard line. And that's where the Gators will take possession with 7:43 left in the second period, and Florida on top of Oklahoma State 17-7. You know, Spear is a good example of a young man who has been around a program. This is his fifth season now at Florida, and I think it underlines the value of fifth-year seniors. Even a guy who maybe won't contribute early on in his career, but by the time he's been around for five seasons, he becomes a real asset.
I think that's the norm in Division I college football these days, is you want a red shirt your freshman. Huey Richardson was a freshman. He could have played.
Kyle Morris is the new quarterback for the Gators, and he threads it to Everett near midfield. What is that, four receptions now for Trey Everett?
Coach Spurrier had mentioned that he wanted to get Kyle Morris in the game probably in the first quarter. He said Shane Matthews was his guy, and it was Shane's ball game, but he wanted to get Kyle Morris into the ball game because he has a lot of confidence in him as well and wanted to see him perform when it counted. And he starts off with a bang right there.
The Gators were 5-1 under Kyle Morris last year before his suspension. Of course, he and Shane Matthews were suspended for their gambling activities. Morris will throw again. Right through the hands of McClendon at the 45-yard line of Oklahoma State.
Well, and there I think you see a subtle difference between Shane Matthews and Kyle Morris. Shane Matthews has been throwing an easy pass to catch. Kyle Morris has the right guy. He makes the right read, but he throws him a rocket. Even though he tried to short arm it, he just tried to flick it out there. He's such an excellent and powerful athlete that he threw a bullet. You gotta, and that's what made Spurrier so great. He could throw the easiest pass to catch. It would just literally float into your hands.
Even a big tight end named Yarborough could catch a few of them, couldn't he?
Yeah, that was a miracle.
Look at the reverse to Terrence Barber. Not a lot of room there, and Barber sneaks underneath an Oklahoma State defender for a couple of yards. Jason Gildon, a freshman, was out there not to be denied on the corner. So Gildon made a nice play. Give him credit. And it will be second down for the Gators inside the 47-yard line of Oklahoma State. Third down, rather. Everett goes wide to the left. Barber comes wide to the near side. Morris.
Oh,
to McClendon, and is he ever hammered by Mike Clark?
He might not get up. Mike Clark, number one, the experienced cornerback, just unloads on Willie McClendon. A fair hit, an excellent hit. The running back is very vulnerable. Here comes the ball, and here comes Clark. Boom.
Lowered his shoulder and hammered number five.
You know, that's not spearing either. He had his face up. What they teach you on defense is to keep your face up, keep your head up, hit them face mask to face mask, nose to nose. Don't duck your head. If he'd have been ducking his head right there, it would have been a spearing job. But right there, it was just an excellent hit. And McClendon says, hey, I'm tougher than that. I'm going to get up and I'll be back.
Guy who averaged 209 yards a game rushing in high school, an incredible career at University Christian High in Jacksonville. Looks like he'll be all right. It is fourth down now.
The first punt of the day for the Gators, David. I asked Coach Spurrier what he thought about his punting game. If he was concerned about it, he said, well, you know, we don't punt much. With his offense, he's not used to punting much. But this is the first punt of the afternoon for the Gators right here.
And it's young Jason Haley. High spiral is going to go into the end zone.
He had a chance, a good kick. He had a chance it would stop.
Oklahoma State will take possession of the football at their 20-yard line. Be sure to watch the Florida Gators here on Sports Channel. Thursday on the 13th, 6:30, Gator Hotline with Steve Spurrier. Saturday the 15th, 11:30, the Gators against the Crimson Tide of Alabama. And on Sunday, the 16th of September at 12 noon, Florida football highlights with Coach Steve Spurrier. Check local listings for availability in your area. 6 minutes, 11 seconds left to play in the second period. And a 17-7 Florida lead over Oklahoma State. Senior quarterback Chris Smith throws the ball away. No receiver anywhere near Mayfield, about 15 or 20 yards upfield. And there is a penalty flag back where Smith delivered the football.
And that's a good call. Again, Smith, not that experienced. He does the right thing initially. He throws the ball away, but he creates the problem by not throwing it into the stands or throwing it deep down the field, at least near a receiver. Throw it out of bounds, of course, but at least get it near your receiver. That ball, there wasn't a cowboy within a hand grenade of that ball.
They mark the ball off down inside the 3-yard line. Let's check in with Steve Babick down on the field.
You know, David, one of the most important pieces of equipment today is a towel. The humidity down here is so high that the ball is so wet that the managers have to keep a dry ball in the game, and so do the players as far as wiping their hands. Also, Willie McClendon took a shot in the ribs. He's okay. He'll be back in on the next offensive series. Back up to you.
Now the 15,000-plus fans in that south end zone are roaring right in the ear of senior Chris Smith. Gives it to his fullback, Wilson, who hammers it out across the five to about the six, Mark Murray. And Godfrey Miles combined to make the stop. Wilson, a big fullback out of Fort Worth, Texas.
Mark Murray seems to be shaken up. Maybe he's just a little tired, or it's his shoulder, it looks like. He's grimacing. Maybe he can shake it off.
An underrated player, wouldn't you say, Jim?
Oh, yeah.
Huey Richardson gets so much notice, but Mark Murray is a very solid player week after week.
I think he led the team in sacks last year, didn't he? Huey's got the career record, but Mark got more, I think, in last year's seasons. Oh, sack!
Huey Richardson. That's a safety. Richardson drops Smith 5 yards deep in the end zone.
I think he comes in on a twist where he comes underneath the offensive tackle. They run a little bit of a game to create confusion at the offensive line. Generally, he's up the field, up the field, up the field. Watch him come up underneath to the inside, and no one has laid a hand on him. Much like in basketball, the two offensive linemen pick each other, and it frees up the defensive end. And he's untouched. And you got to put a hand on that guy, and it's 2 points for the Gators. So the Gator defense puts points on the board.
That's Huey's second sack.
And I think Mark Murray's okay because he sprinted out there to congratulate Huey. Mark was limping off the field, and Huey gets there. Mark says, way to go, Huey. That's the way to go.
I guess officially they've given him 1.5 sacks on the day, so that brings his career total, Huey Richardson, up to 23 quarterback sacks in his career. Alonzo Johnson holds the school record with 27 quarterback sacks. Clifford Charlton would be next with 25, then Wilbur Marshall with 23. So Richardson is just tied, a pretty darn good football player, and Wilbur Marshall for fourth place in the quarterback sack department at Florida.
Well, he and Mark Murray are going to put tremendous pressure on opposing quarterbacks because they're so fast coming upfield on the outside. So opposing quarterbacks are going to have to unload the football in a hurry because they're not going to get a second and third look because those guys are just too good and too fast on the outside, and that's a exciting prospect for this Gator defense.
Terry Blanchard punched the ball away, and the Gators should wind up with good field position here. Monty Duncan brings it out to the 50-yard line, and they do indeed have the ball in excellent field position. Duncan out of St. Augustine, a redshirt freshman.
Now he's backing up Trey Everett and Alonzo Sullivan at a wide receiver position, and he refuses to go down. Of course, after a safety, you have the option of punting or kicking off. They choose to punt. Nice job. That's a big kid running back a punt, isn't it? 6'2", 11".
Gets his hands on the football for the first time in his college career.
Got to have good hands to be a punt returner.
Shane Matthews back at quarterback. McNabb dropped it, then picked it up and runs with it. McNabb across the 40. McNabb won't go down. My goodness, McNabb gallops all the way down to the 14-yard line. Woolridge finally made the tackle. How many tackles did he break?
Well, did the officials blow the call? Was it incomplete, or was it a completion and a fumble? Let's take a look. There's the ball. He seems to have it. I don't know. It was a difficult angle right there, but they didn't blow the whistle. That's a tough call to go against you. It's a great call to go for you.
You dribbled it like a basketball. From the 14-yard line now, the Gators are first down. Nice step by McClendon. And McClendon is to the 5-yard line of Oklahoma State.
Cal Dixon at center doing an excellent job with Chris Bromley, number 52. Dixon is 59. Esam Ismail, 77. Those kids doing an excellent job up front, and probably one of the best tackles in the conference, if not the nation. Glenn Neely, number 70, just doing a terrific job in this ball game. But he was excellent all season long last year, and that was a quick draw after they pass. All of a sudden they come back with that quick draw and nothing but daylight.
Ernie Mills in motion. McClendon gets the handoff. He high steps, and did he get in?
He fumbled.
No signal yet.
He got in but left the ball. Then he went back to get the ball, and he might not have it. They might give this to the Cowboys. They're trying to see who's got it right now.
Officials call a timeout while they unravel the situation. Shane Matthews signals that the Gators have kept possession.
It was a power trap. Had the lead back. Left guard pulls and traps. It was power football, but there's Esam Ishmael. That was Fleischman, wasn't it? Just stripped him of the football. So Gators lucky to maintain possession right there, but they're on the verge of scoring again here in the first half, putting a lot of points on the scoreboard, possibly.
It is third down. Terrell Jackson is now the fullback ahead of Willie McClendon. McClendon over the top and in for the touchdown. Mike Clark trying to deny at the goal line. Nobles also hit him pretty strong. But McClendon scores for the first time this season, his second touchdown for the Gators.
David, the Gators have a touchdown, but the impressive thing is right at this point in the game, they have 302 yards total offense. And how many points? Almost soon to be 26. I'm not used to seeing that.
Johnny Nichols puts it down, and Krzyzewski kicks it through. And the Gators just keep on rolling up the numbers. 26-7 is now the count. We are late in period number two from Florida Field. The situation up 49 yards in just four plays with McClendon carrying it in. It was McClendon's first touchdown of the season. Let me correct, it was not his second touchdown with the Gators. It was his sixth career touchdown running the ball for the Florida Gators. Chris Smith has two receivers wide to the right, just one running back on first down from near the 25. He gives the ball to the tailback Hudson, who is wrapped up by Tim Paulk, the junior inside linebacker out of Carroll City High School in Miami. Has been a big play man for the Gators. No question about that. Mr. Paulk has blocked four punts in his college career.
Yeah, he was probably the most exciting player on that defensive unit last year, with possibly the exception of Huey Richardson. But Paulk is incredibly exciting player with his speed and quickness and his ability to be in the right place at the right time.
And off to Hudson again on a draw. Hudson got maybe another yard before Brad Culpepper made the stop. Number 50, his dad Bruce, an All-Southeastern Conference center for the Florida Gators in the early 60s, and Brad an outstanding player in his own right.
Trying to take some of the steam out of that Gator defense by running a few draws, trying to slow him down a little bit so Smith can get back there and again take advantage of getting the ball to his wide receivers. But Gator defense outstanding on the last possession and on this one as well.
It is third and eight. Almost drew the Gators offside. Smith unloads it quickly and it's incomplete. Good coverage there on the corner by Dell Spear, who's playing that cornerback spot now with Jimmy Spencer out of the ball game for that series. So Spear, the sophomore out of Miami, a younger brother of James Spear, made a nice play that time to bring up fourth down for Oklahoma State. Blanchard has kicked three times for an average of 33.7 yards per kick. There comes Paulk, but he got knocked down by Fleischman at the last minute. Fair catch again called for by Terrence Barber at the 34-yard line.
Smart play. No place to go there.
With 1 minute and 50 seconds left in the first half, the Gators leading Oklahoma State 26-7. They have been totally in command of this game from the opening kick. The offense has racked up over 300 yards. The defense, with only one exception, when Oklahoma State marched down the field and scored its only touchdown, has been outstanding as well. Eric Rett is the new tailback, the lone back behind Matthews, who's getting pressure this time, but he's got Kirkpatrick open, and the big tight end has the football, and out of bounds he goes at the 43-yard line. Linebacker Mike Woolridge made the stop, but a gain of nine.
Kirkpatrick was the primary receiver. He hesitates a moment and then runs a 45-degree angle towards the sideline, sits down, waits for the ball, picks up 8 yards. I think Kirkpatrick is going to catch 50 or 60 passes this year. He'll probably be disappointed if he didn't get that many, because he's going to be very involved in this Gator offense. Tight end has to be if they're going to have passing success, and Steve Spurrier is a genius at doing that.
1:43 left in the half. Gators run Eric Rett, and Rett has the first down to the 49-yard line. Woolridge again made the stop. Rett, a redshirt freshman from South Florida, Pembroke Pines and MacArthur High School, played sparingly.
Garcia Mattingly, report to
just a couple of games last year, 23 plays.
Gators calling the plays at the line of scrimmage right now in a hurry-up offense. Want to get some more points.
Flag is down as Kirkpatrick catches the ball and takes it to the 35-yard line.
Matthews pass and lead to Kirkpatrick. Flag on the play.
But let's check the flag, which was thrown back near the line of scrimmage.
Maybe a couple of guys in motion at the same time, but Steve's arguing the point. He won't win that one, but the Gators in a hurry-up offense, you know, they're not satisfied, and that's the way to play this game. Get down the field, get more points. They're in a hurry-up, two-minute offense. Now they have the time to go back to the huddle because the clock is stopped.
Kirkpatrick becomes even more valuable, Jim, when you consider the ability of the wide receivers to catch the football. That puts so much pressure on a defensive secondary deep and in middle range pass coverage. And the Gators so far today have proven that they can catch the ball at the wideout position.
And that's not been a strength of this ball club. Everyone kept hoping it would be, but until this year, it really hasn't been. And now all of a sudden, the guys are doing the job.
Although Mills was unable to hold on to that one at the 40-yard line. Pretty good coverage, though, however, by Fred Gaines.
Yeah, Fred Gaines was right in his lap, but again, Shane Matthews was on the button there, wasn't he? At least he gave his wide receiver the chance to come up with a great catch. It was there. But back to the wide receivers, one of the things that did impress me in reading Coach Spurrier's comments was that he thought he had a talented group of wide receivers to work with, and he was very excited about the group that was going to be playing wide receiver position for the Gators this year, and they're going to give them a chance to be stars.
Second down and 15. Matthews dumps it softly to Eric Rett. And Rett across the 50 to the 46-yard line. A gain of almost 10. Fred Gaines again made the tackle. The safety out of Dallas, Texas.
Big Mark White a bit shaken up there, but he sacrifices his body and hurries back to the line of scrimmage. The big, strong right tackle, number 60. Boy, is that offensive line doing a great job. Timeout. Coach is calling timeout. They don't see it, though.
It's third down with time running out in the period. 25 seconds left. Kirkpatrick is not going to get the first down. In fact, he just did get back to the line of scrimmage. There are 15 seconds now left. Clock continues to run. And time has been called. But the question is, who called timeout, Oklahoma State or Florida? Steve Spurrier has called timeout. It's going to be fourth down and about five for the Gators with 12 seconds left in the second period. Florida leading 26-7. And Spurrier chatting with Shane Matthews on the near sideline. So what do you think the coach and the quarterback are cooking up down there? The Gators already have a 19-point advantage here, but Coach Spurrier is trying to take him in for more before the first half ends.
Well, he's either going to bomb him in the end zone all the way, or he's going to try and get the first down very quickly so they'll have a chance at an extremely long field goal. Probably he's going to try and pick up that first down, get out of bounds. Was that the last timeout of the half? So they got to get out of bounds, right? I think they might have used up their last timeout. So.
Yeah, it was.
Of course, it's fourth down anyway, but if they complete it, if they pick up the first down, they've got to get out of bounds, although the clock would stop with the chains, but it wouldn't stop for long.
Matthews looking to throw it, and he underthrows his receiver. I think that's Alonzo Sullivan inside the 30-yard line. It is Sullivan, and Oklahoma State will take possession at the 46-yard line. 7 seconds left. Oklahoma State still has one timeout left.
Well, even if that ball had been completed, again, there was no timeouts. The clock would have stopped temporarily for the chains to move, but they never would have gotten a field goal off right there. I think that's the thing that probably discouraged Steve Spurrier, was that they weren't able to complete the pass and get out of bounds and get a chance at a field goal. He wants the full plate, you know.
He's gotten a pretty good serving so far this afternoon. His team up 26-7, having racked up over 300 yards in offense. The Gators rush only three. Play action. Mark Murray almost got the sack. Smith throws it up for grabs. It's knocked down. As the first half comes to a close, Will White hoping to get a late pass interception.
And Richard Fain there. Both of them had their eyes on that.
Fighting over. Well, an excellent first half of football for the Florida Gators. They go into the locker room with a whopping 26-7 lead over Oklahoma State out of the Big 8 Conference. We'll be back with more from Florida Field in just one moment.